Welcome to Buena Vida Route. Today we're going to show you what La Chata looked like when we bought her and how she has progressed after many months of hard work. Please forgive that when we started, we had no video equipment and really didn't know what we were doing. We have hopefully improved since then. As you can see, this is our shower and bathroom area. You can see the water damage up on the ceiling and how all the cabinetry was brown, the wallpaper on the back and all the vinyl flooring. Everything was full of carpet that we had to remove. The front of the refrigerator is all brown as well. And that very hideous upholstery that thank goodness we changed. As well as those ugly gathered curtains. All of that area as well was covered in carpet, which Andres removed. As you can also see, all four of the corners had water damage, so we had to take it down to the bare fiberglass and then put in new insulation, new wood, and new plywood over it. All the cabinetry we painted white, inside and out. Here you can see that the two bunk bed corners were fixed. And as you can see, we had to take out all the fixtures in order to paint all around it. We also went ahead on the outside and removed all the trim, all the windows and all the doors. So as you can see, we went ahead and cleaned everything off and then put a Terrabond tape, which is a waterproofing tape, so that all seams would be waterproof once we went ahead and put the trim back on. All the windows and doors of the compartments and the main door got put all brand new butyl tape. And after we went ahead and painted La Chata, we sealed it all off with new sealant. Here you can see how the floor was down to the plywood. And the bathroom has gotten a brand new white paint. We even painted the shower bottom. We red guard all of the walls on this area since they're exposed so much to water. That's another corner that we have to fix inside of our closet. And all the vents got replaced. We took out our toilet. We have not taken out our black tank, but we did take out the toilet because we didn't want to have a flushing toilet for when we started traveling throughout Latin America. So here we've painted the bottom cabinetry a seafoam blue because, as you know, La Chata is a dolphin, and so of course we went with a nautical theme. This is inside the cabin. We removed the seats and removed all of the flooring and went ahead and insulated the flooring and then put brand new vinyl flooring in it. Going on the outside, Andres went ahead and changed all of the outer lights for LEDs. And you can see here Andres underneath the belly of the car, scraping away all the rust. He went ahead and sanded it and then painted it all with anti-corrosive paint, so we would no longer have rust problems. Again, on the outside here, this was our first attempt to make La Chata look a little bit prettier. So we here had removed all the outer decals and had painted the window frames a royal blue. Afterwards, we decided that that blue was a little too strong, so we went ahead and replaced them with a pretty similar seafoam blue as the inside. And now here we have progressed where we have put a backsplash in. Originally we had put this backsplash in, which was basically like stickers that looked like tile. They unfortunately did not last very long, and so we ended up having to replace those, as you will see in a future video. Here all the doors have been painted and the handles we spray painted, and I wrapped them in a jute twine to give them more of a nautical theme. And here we're moving on to continue and removing all of that, but all those upper lights were changed to LEDs as well. Doing one of these cars is a lot of work. Don't think that you get one of these and automatically everything is done. In this part of the video, you can see how we had done the red guard all inside of the shower. And then after that, we installed FRP panels, which are basically like a plastic PVC material that we sealed off with silicone so we would never have to worry about it ever rotting again. That backsplash eventually I covered with the same stickers as the backsplash in the bathroom, in the kitchen, yet we also eventually replaced it, as you will see in a future video. Here you can see that we are trying out our new LED lights on the inside. They're great. They dimmer so you can make them brighter or lighter. And I created this panel in order to create a hand painting on the inside of the bottom cabinetry. Then we went ahead and installed our awning, and it gave us the opportunity to go ahead and install a tent on the outside. This tent is 8 by 8 by 10 feet tall, so it's nice and big for whenever we have guests or if you just want to have an outside space to be able to take advantage of. So we can definitely put in an inflatable mattress in there, and easily even 4 people can sleep in it. But we can also go ahead and put our picnic table in there and not have to worry about bugs. This is how we solve the issue of air coming in through the door as we were driving, as well as it jingling as we were driving. So we insulated in the middle between the screen and the door itself, and we went ahead and screwed it into the door so that there wouldn't be any movement. Here I'm explaining all of the little things that we still needed to do, like the plumbing on the hot water heater and the pump that was broken, and that wall of that cubby was loose, and so we ended up having to brace it. And here you can see our first attempt at a final look for La Chata, which has since changed quite a bit. Yet here you can see all the details, sort of like that ladder with the nautical knots, the hand painting on the inside. We had originally covered our tabletop with a map that we could put the places that we were going to be going to or have been to. We have some decorative items, as some boats that my husband has collected, and pillows that we made ourselves. We keep a couple of rugs on the floor. It makes it easier to clean out the floor and also keeps the floors nice and toasty for when we travel in the cold weather. Those pillows were made with a patchwork of fabrics that I had taken from remnants. So be creative. You could always use an upcycle material. You will see more of that when you see the second video of this series. You can also see there that we exchanged our flushing toilet for a compostable toilet that is currently also getting an upgrade, and installed boat cleats as hooks. Again, following the nautical theme. We customized a shower curtain that I'm showing you there, and we have another hook for our hand towel. And then we went ahead and sliced a bunch of corks, yes, wine corks, and install them as the countertop with epoxy grout. They never moved a bit. You can see some of our pictures there. It's a great countertop material because you could put your hot pans over it and it won't burn. Also, you can drop anything and it won't break. Sadly, that is now gone, and we have replaced it with something else, which you will see in future videos. So please subscribe and stay tuned for the next videos in this series. can see our pillows there on top of our bed. The windows also got brand new curtains that were insulated and with blackout, which is a perfect solution for when you want to be able to sleep a little longer in campgrounds or when you're boondocking. We added some shelves that I call my nightstand. Here we had a cutting board on top of our table that we were hoping that was going to work as a tabletop, but we ended up not. So eventually we ditched it because it was a little clunky and heavy to carry around. We added privacy curtains that we can go ahead and shut closed so that if we're on the inside, nobody can see us through the main cabin. Added a little trash can, and you can see us enjoying here our first meal in La Chata, and Andres on his phone. This is us in Monument Valley for one of our road trips. This video is in honor of my father, who today would have been 73 years old. Thank you for watching.